So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 16th of December and to 18th of December 2022. So let's begin with the session without any delay and let's talk about the very first question, right? Which says, very important question guys, because it is about a scheme जो कि हमने पहले कभी नहीं पढ़ी है and ये news में generally नहीं रहती है, so you can expect a question out of it, right? Consider the following statements with respect to Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching and you have to identify the correct statements, right? An exam में please focus on this word, whether you have to identify the correct statement or the incorrect statement, because generally ये mistake हो जाती है. In case of correct statement, हम जल्दीबाजी में इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करके आ जाते हैं, सो प्लीज डोंट डू सच मिस्टेक्स, राइट? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस स्कीम गाइस. सो रिमेंबर इट इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज रिगार्डिंग दिस अ रिप्लाई हैज बीन सबमिटेड इन द पार्लियामेंट बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन, राइट? सो फर्स्ट वन थिंग इज क्लियर दैट दिस स्कीम इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन विच इज हेडेड बाय धर्मेंद्र प्रधान. ऑलराइट, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस स्कीम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव, so objectives are really very easy to determine from the name only, right? Naam se hi hame jo scheme ka naam hota hai usi se hame objective determine ho jata hai, right? So what is the name of the scheme? National Mission on Teachers and Training, which means some kind of training is being provided or will be provided under this scheme to improve the quality of teachers and hence to improve the quality of education. That is the major objective of this scheme, right? Now let's read the objectives: to provide quality teachers in schools and colleges, attract talented people in the education sector and improve quality in education. So this is what I told you guys, ki yahi ek basic iska objective hai, right? To set the teaching standards so that an organized cadre of professional teachers can be created, so there should be a standard of teaching below which teaching should not be done, right? And to develop innovative teaching method. Of course, जो टीचिंग है वो ऐसा प्रोफेशन है जिसमें यू नीड टू डेवलप योरसेल्फ, राइट? जैसे मैं आज टीचर हूं, मैं अगर एक ही तरीके से अगले 10 साल तक पढ़ाता रहूंगा तो वो वर्क नहीं कर पाएगा, राइट? सो देयर इज अ डिमांड ऑफ इनोवेटिव मेथड्स ऑफ टीचिंग एंड दीज मेथड्स दीज डिमांड्स विल बी फुलफिल्ड थ्रू दीज ट्रेनिंग विच आर बींग प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस स्कीम, राइट? द स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2014 अप टू 2020, विच मीन्स द स्कीम The implementation of period of this scheme has been completed and till now there is no extension. अभी तक कोई extension नहीं है, right? Implementing ministry मैंने आपको बता दिया, it is Ministry of Education. The total outlay of this scheme was rupees 900 crores and it was a central sector scheme, right? Central sector scheme means the entire funding is borne by the central government. And then we have a centrally sponsored scheme. What is the meaning of centrally sponsored? Centrally sponsored scheme का मतलब होता है the funding is shared between the center and states, right? So it is a central sector scheme. Now it comprehensively addressed all the issues related to teaching, like for example professional development, curriculum design, developing assessment, evaluation methodology, everything, right? So this is all about the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear and it is an important scheme. It can be asked in your examination, right? So let's come back to the question now. The question is, you have to identify the correct statement. It is being implemented by Ministry of Education, correct? It was launched in 2012. Is that so? No. It was launched in 2014. And the scheme has a total outlay of 900 crore, which is correct, which means 1 and 3 are correct statement. Option C will be the correct statement. All right. Let's talk about question number 2. Again, an important question. Recently, the Golden Jubilee of Northeastern Council has been celebrated. You have to identify incorrect statement out of these 5 with respect to the council. Now, generally, इस तरीके के question RBI में या NABARD में नहीं आते हैं. But yes, it is an organization and it has completed Golden Jubilee, right? Golden Jubilee इसकी complete हुई है, so it becomes important because again, it is a part of this council. Works for economic and social development of the northeastern region, and that is why this can be asked in your ESI part, right? That economic and social issues ka jo aapka part hai usme aa sakta hai ye. So let's talk about it. So it is the statutory body, and what is the meaning of statutory body? the statutory bodies are those which are established through any parliament act, right? So it is a statutory body which was established through Northeastern Council Act of 1971, right? It serves as the nodal agency for economic and social development of Northeastern region, as I told you guys. The parent ministry, of course, when we are talking about Northeastern areas, the ministry should be the Ministry of Development of Northeastern region, which is headed by Mr. G. Kishan Reddy. G. Kishan Reddy, right? And he is also the Minister of Tourism and Culture. It was established in 1972. The act was enacted in 1971, but it was established in 1972. Right, and it is headquartered in Shillong. And where is Shillong? It is in Meghalaya, of course. Right, talking more about it, so member states, all the northeastern states are member of this Northeastern Council. Sikkim was added to it in the year 2002 through an amendment act. All right, composition ki agar hum baat kare to the Union Home Minister, who is currently Mr. Amit Shah. Mr. Amit Shah is the Union Home Minister. I hope you all know this. So, Union Home Minister is the ex officio chairperson, right? And Minister of State in Ministry of Development of the Northeastern region, or you can say, because वहाँ पे जो Ministry of Development of Northeastern region है, उसमें independent charge ही होता है. So, whoever is the Minister of Development of Northeastern region, which currently is Mr. G. Kishan Reddy, is the ex officio vice chairperson. All right. And members के रूप में there are the chief ministers and governors of all the northeastern states. All right, so that is all about this council. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement. It is a statutory body established under NEC Act of 1971. Sahi baat hai, no problem. It serves as the nodal agency for economic and social development of northeastern region. Correct. 8 northeastern states of these are its member. Ye bhi sahi hai. It functions under Ministry of Development of Northeastern region. बिल्कुल सही बात है. तो करेक्ट आंसर हमारा ऑप्शन ई होना चाहिए. मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन इज इट्स एक्स ऑफिशियो चेयरपर्सन. नो, ही और शी इज द एक्स ऑफिशियो वाइस चेयरपर्सन. हाउएवर द एक्स ऑफिशियो चेयरपर्सन इज द यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर. जो होम मिनिस्टर होते हैं वो इसके एक्स ऑफिशियो चेयरपर्सन होते हैं, विच मीन्स द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट? ऑप्शन ई, बिकॉज दिस इज द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. ऑलराइट, आगे चलते हैं क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 पे. Where will India Energy Week 2023 be organized by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, headed by Hardeep Singh Puri? And Hardeep Singh Puri is also the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs. Right? Supported by Indian Oil and Federation of Indian Petroleum Industry in February 2023. So, abhi hum isliye padh rahe hain because a curtain raiser iske regarding hua tha. So, you never know, they can ask you question in any recent exam. So, this India Energy Week 2023 will take place in Bangalore. It will take place in Bangalore with the objective to showcase India as both an engine of global economic growth and driver for global consumption. So basically, in short, agar hum iske objective ki baat kare, to India energy outlook hai na ye. India energy se related jo bhi hai ye, to isme India ka energy ke area mein, especially in the renewable energy area, kya contribution hai and what will be the contribution in future. All these things will be discussed. All right, the tagline is growth. One second, the tagline is growth, collaboration, transition. Do remember the tagline, it is important. Growth, collaboration, transition. And it will be organized by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and Indian Oil and Federation of Indian Petroleum Industry. All right, so that is all. And as I told you already, the correct answer is option C, Bangalore. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 पे आ जाते हैं. द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ ओपन नेटवर्क फॉर डिजिटल कॉमर्स, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इट इन डिटेल व्हेन इट वाज लॉन्च्ड. सो बेसिकली इट प्रोवाइड्स एन ओपन नेटवर्क एज द नेम सजेस्ट फॉर डिजिटल कॉमर्स, राइट, विच कैन बी एक्सेस बाय एनी सेलर और एनी बायर. ओके, सो ओपन नेटवर्क फॉर डिजिटल कॉमर्स का हेडक्वार्टर इनॉग्रेट हुआ है न्यू दिल्ली में. दिस इज अगेन एन इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन दैट दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड, दैट वेयर हैज द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ ONDC been inaugurated. So in that case the answer would be New Delhi. But here we you have to identify incorrect statement about ONDC. So let's talk about ONDC in detail. Remember, these are the three major objectives of establishing ONDC. Number 1, democratization and decentralization of e-commerce so that everyone has the access of digital e-commerce, right? And sabka uske upar equal right ho. So that is why the word democratization, inclusivity and access for sellers, especially SMEs, as well as the local businesses, and increased choices and independency for consumers. All right, so that is something which will be provided by Open Network for Digital Commerce. It was launched last year, 2021, and remember, it is a non-profit Section 8 company. Section 8 company under Companies Act of 2013, do remember this, right? And it is an initiative of DPIIT, which is Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, headed by Piyush Goyal. The authorized capital of this is 500 crore, and this 500 crore consists of funding from various banks, from various financial institutions. That is not important for your examination, because agar ek do hote, to that would be important. But there are various, right? So that is not required. Board members, 12. 12 board members honge isme, including 3 nominees from the Government of India side, from the Ministries of Commerce and Industry, Ministry of MSME, and Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Okay? So the representatives from these 3 ministries will be there out of these 12 board members. Okay? And pilot phase mein isko April 2022 mein launch kiya gaya hai, 5 cities mein, New Delhi, Bangalore, Bhopal, Shillong and Coimbatore. Right? Do remember the name of these 5 cities where this has been launched in a pilot mode. Okay, so that is all about ONDC, and now let's come back to the question. Incorrect statement we have to identify. It is a statutory regulatory body. No, it is not a statutory body. There is no act which has established it. So it is not a statutory body, it is a non-profit company under Section 8 of Companies Act of 2013, which means this will be the correct answer, because we have to identify what? The incorrect statement. Moving ahead to question number 5. Very important question again, something new. कोई एक नई स्कीम है जो कि अगेन रिप्लाई में आई है सामने. हालांकि वैसे ये नई नहीं है, ये लॉन्च हो चुकी है कुछ सालों पहले, बट हमारे सामने पहली बार आई है इन पार्लियामेंट्री रिप्लाई. सो दिस स्कीम इज सब स्कीम भारतीय प्राकृतिक कृषि पद्धति. राइट, भारतीय प्राकृतिक कृषि. प्राकृतिक कृषि मीन्स वॉट? ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग, नेचुरल फार्मिंग. राइट, प्राकृतिक मतलब वॉट? नेचुरल. एंड कृषि मीन्स वॉट? फार्मर. सो आई होप आपको इसका आइडिया अब तक में लग गया होगा, वट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम. राइट, सो लेट्स, यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट एंड देन वी विल कम बैक टू दिस क्वेश्चन. सो ऑब्जेक्टिव इज, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव, द ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू प्रमोट द नेचुरल फार्मिंग. द ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू प्रमोट द नेचुरल फार्मिंग. राइट, दैट इज वन थिंग विच इज क्लियर. बट दिस, हाउ दिस नेचुरल फार्मिंग विल बी प्रमोटेड? So this scheme is focused on farm biomass recycling, right? On farm biomass recycling, with major stress on biomass mulching, right? Use of cow dung, urine formulations. सारी चीजें हम organic use कर रहे हैं, natural use कर रहे हैं, and exclusion of all synthetic chemical inputs in the farming. All right. It was launched in the year 2019-20, and it will be implemented up to 2024-25. And yes, question में आपने देखा होगा, it is a sub scheme under प्रधान परंपरागत कृषि विकास योजना. Right? Remember this thing. It is a sub scheme. So under which scheme it is a sub scheme? So it is a sub scheme under परंपरागत कृषि विकास योजना. All right. And total outlay of this scheme is 4645.49 crores. This is also important. You should remember it. ठीक है, थोड़ा अलग सा नंबर है, बट दीज डेज द डिमांड ऑफ द एग्जामिनर इज क्वाइट हाई. ही और शी इज एक्सपेक्टिंग अलॉट फ्रॉम यू, सो यू हैव टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड इन दैट मैनर ओनली. राइट, 4645.49 crores. टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट इट, सो दीज आर दी सम ऑफ द कैटेगरीज ऑफ फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस विच इज बींग प्रोवाइडेड टू द फार्मर्स अंडर दिस स्कीम. सो नंबर 1, 12,200 पर हेक्टेयर for a period of 3 years. Now please don't confuse it with 51,000 per hectare for 3 years. That is being provided under Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Right? So 12,200 per hectare for 3 years is provided for cluster formation of the organic products, capacity building and hand holding by trained personnel, which means the training is also being provided to the farmers for promoting the natural farming, for motivating them to do the organic farming. Right? Then out of this 12,200, remember 2,000 rupees is directly provided to the farmer through DBT. Rupees 2,700 per hectare is provided for obtaining the PGS certification. What is PGS certification? So PGS certification, basically it is a certification for organic produce. If I am a farmer and I am growing any organic product, then I have to, then my product has to be certified under this PGS certification, right? So 2,700 per hectare is provided for PGS certification and residue analysis for 3 years, right? And then 8,800 per hectare for 3 years is provided from PKVY funds, Pradhan Mantri Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana funds, for marketing, right, for value addition and for publicity of natural farming products. See, the natural farming products ki publicity is very important, because kya hota hai na ki ab hum koi cheez nahi leke aa rahe hain market mein to hame logo ko jagana padta hai, right? Aapne wo slogan suna hoga, jago grahak jago. However, wo yahan ke context mein sahi nahi baithega, but yes, हमें कंज्यूमर्स को जगाना पड़ता है कि ओके, दीज आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट जो कि अभी अभी मार्केट में आया है. सो यू गाइस शुड यूज इट. ऑलराइट, सो फॉर दैट आल्सो 8,800 पर हेक्टेयर फॉर 3 इयर्स इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड. ऑलराइट, आई होप दिस स्कीम इज क्लियर एंड लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. इट इज अ सब स्कीम अंडर राष्ट्रीय कृषि विकास योजना. इज दैट सो? नो, परंपरागत कृषि विकास योजना. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2014-15, नहीं, 2019-20. And it is being implemented in all states and UTs. Okay, let me tell you one more thing, that this scheme has been, this scheme is being implemented in 8 states. 8 states mein ye scheme implemented ho rahi hai. Aur ye 8 states kaun se hai, ye main PDF mein update kar dunga, don't worry. Alright. And now let's move ahead to the question in short. But before we begin, let me tell you, if you want to have the PDF of this session with marked answers, you can follow this Telegram channel. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. And yes, to ace the examination this year, the live class courses are already started. So you can join the courses, and for that you have to visit anujindal.in. All right. So let's talk about question number 6 then. Under Grameen Krishi Mausam Seva Program - in collaboration with IMD, which is India Meteorology Organization, is issuing agromet advisories twice a week, which means advisories related to weather, related to climate, related to any, typhoon, flood, ye sari cheeze advisory di jati hai twice a week, which is on Tuesday and Friday, to around 6 crore farmers of the country. Fill the gap. And this advisory is provided through M Kisan portal, through text messages or through WhatsApp messages, right, to the farmers. ठीक है, सो विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज प्रोवाइडिंग इट? इट इज इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च, ऑप्शन सी, इन कोलैबोरेशन विद आईएमडी. ऑलराइट, ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड देयर इज नथिंग मच टू स्टडी इन ग्रामीण कृषि मौसम सेवा प्रोग्राम, एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव टेकन दिस सिंगल क्वेश्चन ऑन इट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल बी लॉन्चिंग 1 week 1 lab कंट्री वाइड थीम बेस्ड कैंपेन टू इग्नाइट द माइंड्स ऑफ यंग इनोवेटर्स, students, startups, academia, and industry to look for opportunity through deep tech ventures. All right. One second, guys. All right. Which organization will be launching 1 week 1 lab campaign? So this organization, ये हमने पहले भी discuss किया था. So this organization is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR. Now, who is the ex officio president of CSIR? It's the Prime Minister of India. Prime Minister of India is the ex officio president. And recently, I think 2-3 months before, we have a new director general, and the first woman director general of CSIR, it's N. Kalai Selvi. N. Kalai Selvi. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. N. Kalai Selvi. If I'm not wrong, it is the name. She is the first woman director general of CSIR. Okay. अगर इसमें कुछ करेक्शन होगी तो मैं बता दूंगा. आई बिलीव इट इज दिस ओनली एन कलाई सेल्वी, बट ठीक है, अगर कुछ करेक्शन होगी तो आई टेल यू गाइस. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. विच मिनिस्ट्री इंप्लीमेंट्स शहरी वक्फ संपत्ति विकास योजना थ्रू सेंट्रल वक्फ काउंसिल टू प्रोवाइड इंटरेस्ट फ्री लोन टू वक्फ इंस्टीट्यूशन, वक्फ बोर्ड्स, for taking up economically viable projects on the urban work land such as commercial complexes, marriage halls, hospitals, cold storages, etc. Now for such questions for such schemes basically there is no need to go into much details, because if any question will come from this scheme, that question will be this only, from these four or five lines mein se hi question hoga, right? Because generally they pick questions from the PIB only, aur is scheme ke document ko khol ke to examiner scheme banane wala nahi hai definitely. Okay, that happens in the case of the major schemes like sovereign gold bond, like manrega, like pradhan mantri gram sadak yojana, right? Waisa hota unke case mein. But for such schemes they are going to pick up news or question from PIB release only. All right, and this scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Minority Affairs headed by Smriti Irani. Question number 9, Indian Railways National Rail Plan has envisages to increase the share of freight traffic by rail from current share of 27% to how much percent by 2030. Ye humne pehle bhi discuss kiya hai, but let's discuss it again. It is 45%. Option B is the correct answer. Very, very important question. Question number 10, with which organization National Education Society for Tribal Students, which in short is NEST, has collaborated to develop an e-learning platform, which is Eklavya Learning Management System, ELMS, to enable a comprehensive learning environment for students in EMRS, which is Eklavya Model Residential Schools. Now these schools are meant for the tribal students, right? And if you want to study this scheme in detail, you can search for Anu Jindal Government Schemes. You will find a playlist. There I have discussed the scheme in detail. और अगर नहीं मिले तो बता देना, आई विल डिस्कस इट. एंड वैसे रिवीजन के टाइम पे तो मैं सारी स्कीम डिस्कस करता ही हूँ, सो डोंट वरी, सब कुछ कवर होगा. नाउ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज सीडैक, सेंटर फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एडवांस कंप्यूटिंग. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन हैड लॉन्च्ड द नेशनल क्रेडिट फ्रेमवर्क टू एनेबल द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ एकेडमिक एंड वोकेशनल डोमेन्स to ensure flexibility and mobility between the two, right? So there is a framework, national credit framework, to enable the integration of academic and vocational domains, right? This framework intends towards integration of academic and vocational domains, right? It is an inclusive umbrella framework to seamlessly integrate the credits earned through school education, higher education and vocational and skill education. So when was this framework released? Very easy question. This was discussed this year, and remember it was launched this year only, 2022. Option E is the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number 12. What was the rate of participation of women in Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme during the financial year 2021 and 2022? Very, very important question. Bahut important hai. So for 2020-2021, it was 53.19%, and in the financial year 22 it increased a bit to 54.71%, right? So what is the correct answer then? Yeah, option D, 53.19 and 54.71% respectively for 2019-20 and 21-22. theek hai ji. 13 pe aao. How many food irradiation facilities are operational in the country in private, semi government and government sector for irradiation of various products? Now what is the meaning of irradiation of various products? So remember, the radiation processing of grains increases its quality. ठीक है, तो जो grains की, जैसे cereal हो गए, rice हो गए, pulses हो गए, इनका जो radiation इनके ऊपर दी जाती है to improve its quality, right? So radiation processing of grains, spices and their products can help in maintaining their quality for a year, and in case of onion and potato it maintains their quality for around 8 months. ठीक है, and currently 25 such facilities are operational in the country. Option D is the correct answer. आगे चलते हैं question number 14 पे, and there are 20 questions today. So Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions is celebrating second Good Governance Week from 19th to 25th of December, and remember 25th December in India is celebrated as Good Governance Day. Why it is celebrated as Good Governance Day? Because that is the birthday of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ex Prime Minister. Which nationwide campaign will be organized during this week to create a national movement for good governance in furtherance of the initiative towards a citizen-centric approach of governance. So, I think आपको आंसर अब तक में मिल गया होगा. It is प्रशासन गांव की ओर. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज इंक्रीज्ड द एमएसपी फॉर वीट फॉर राबी मार्केटिंग सीजन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल ईयर 23. सो व्हाट इज द एमएसपी फॉर दिस सीजन. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन नबार्ड एग्जामिनेशन बिकॉज इंक्रीज हुआ है और गवर्नमेंट की आदत होती है और इनफैक्ट सभी की आदत होती है कि अगर वो कोई अच्छा काम करते हैं तो वो दिखाए. मेरी भी आदत है, आपकी भी होगी. तो उसी तरीके से ये भी क्वेश्चन आपके एग्जाम में आ सकता है. सो द प्राइस इज नाउ 2125 पर क्विंटल. ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मेक इन इंडिया 2.0 इज फोकस्ड ऑन 27 सेक्टर्स एज वी ऑल नो. और मेक इन इंडिया बहुत बार हम डिस्कस कर चुके हैं और पीडीएफ में भी आप लोगों को दे चुका हूं मैं. सो 27 सेक्टर्स पे है. तो मैं ये क्वेश्चन क्यों लेके आया, बिकॉज एक थोड़ी सी अलग इन्फॉर्मेशन है यहाँ पे. हालांकि ये भी आप में से कई लोगों को ऑलरेडी पता होगी. पता है तो अच्छी बात है, नहीं पता है तो पढ़ लो. आउट ऑफ 21 सेक्टर्स हाउ मेनी आर इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड हाउ मेनी आर इन सर्विस. सो आउट ऑफ 27, 15 सेक्टर्स बिलोंग टू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर एंड 12 बिलोंग टू सर्विस सेक्टर. ऑलराइट, तो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी 15, 12. Among all the steps taken by the government of India to boost exports, extension of foreign trade policy is a major one. So the current policy was initially it was for 2015 to 20. Then it was extended, bar bar extend hua. Last time September 2022 tak tha, but again in the month of October 2022 it has been extended for a period of 6 months more. And now it will be implemented or it will be followed till 31st March 2023, which means option A is the correct answer. Question number 18 pe aa jate hain. The traditional knowledge digital library is a pioneering Indian initiative jointly implemented by CSIR and Ministry of Ayush, which is headed by Sarbanand Sonowal, right? This digital library is to prevent exploitation and to protect Indian traditional knowledge from misappropriation by way of wrongful intellectual property rights. Okay? It contains Indian traditional medicine knowledge from classical or traditional texts related to Ayush, which is Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha, Soa, Rigpa, yoga techniques in a digitized format. Right? It is available in 5 international languages to patent examiners. Which of the following are the international languages in which it is available? Okay? So these languages, guys, are English, French, German, Spanish, and Japanese. All of the above is the correct answer. All right. Aage chalte hai. When was the Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers' Rights Act enacted by the Parliament for establishment of an effective system फॉर प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ प्लांट वराइटीज. और इसको लेकर आजकल थोड़े सी झगड़े भी चल रहे हैं. द राइट्स ऑफ फार्मर्स एंड प्लांट ब्रीडर्स एंड टू एनकरेज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ न्यू वराइटीज ऑफ प्लांट्स. सो व्हेन वाज दिस एक्ट इनेक्टेड. सो इट वाज इन द ईयर 2001 व्हेन दिस एक्ट वाज इनेक्टेड. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड यस, यू डोंट हैव टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस एक्ट, नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जाम. एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे. India is net exporter of which of the following agri commodities? So India is a net exporter of wheat, rice, not pulses, jowar and bajra. 1, 2, 4 and 5. So in case of pulses, we are net importer because of high demand of pulses in the country and less production. So 1, 2, 4 and 5, option C is the correct answer. Alright, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. So I will see you in the next session on Friday. Goodbye, take care and God bless.